This call is now being recorded.
Hi children, this is second video from the topic current electricity. In the previous video I told you that the length of the video is going to be very large, so that's why I cut short. I am making 3 videos per chapter now. Total 15 questions are divided into 3 parts. So in the part 1, I have uploaded 5 numericals from current electricity chapter. This is video number 3.2 of current electricity chapter. So let us go for the numericals one by one. So this series of videos is especially for those who are preparing for NEET examination, NEET UG examination 2021. So let us go for the numericals. The first numerical in video number 3.2 is, in the circuit shown in figure, V must be. So what is the value of V? If you see this circuit, it appears to be quite complex, but it is very simple network. We do one thing, let us name the corners. Let this be A, let this be B. Then here we have a junction, let it be C. Here we have another one, D. This is E, this is F. If you see the circuit diagram, I draw A here, I take A here and I take B here. Ultimately, you need to find the potential difference between the terminals A and B. Okay. So from A, we have a resistance 4 ohm, right? Let us take 4. Next, B. We have B here. B is connected to F. So you take B here, let it be F point F, this is point F. So between F and B, we have 6 ohm. E and F are together, so this is E as well as F. Next, after A, after 4 ohm, we have point C here. Let us keep point C here. Between C and E, there is 20 ohm. So draw 20 ohm here. Next, D and C are connected. See this? D and C are connected. So let us name it as D also. That means the two terminals are same. C and D are same. They are connected by means of a conducting wire. Now between C and E, 20, we have drawn already. Between E and D, we have 100. E is here, D is here. We have 100 ohm. So let us draw 100 also in parallel to this 100. Next, between E and D, 100, D and F. D and F, we have 25. D is here, F is here. So another 25. That's all. The total current flowing through the circuit is 5 ampere. So your target is to find the effective resistance of the network, thereby the voltage, right? First of all, these three are parallel. Let us find the effective of this 1 by 25 plus 1 by 100 plus 1 by 20 is equal to 1 by R. LCM is 100. We'll get 4. 1 plus 5, 1 by R, 4 plus 5 plus 1 is 10, 10 by 100 is 1 by 10, R equal to 10. So this entire resistance is equal to 10. Apart from that, we have in series with 10, 4 ohm here, 6 ohm here, 4 plus 6, 10 plus 10, 20. So in the circuit, the total resistance is 20 ohm. ohm and the current is 5 ampere. So between A and B, the potential difference is I into R total, which is 5 into 20, 100 volt. Done. So the moment you see the circuit, you feel that is it going to be a Wheatstone's bridge, or all these in parallel or series? Don't get confused. Let us name the terminals first. We name it as A, C, E, D, F, B, like this. Then whichever are connected together, C and D are connected, bring them together. Between E and F there is nothing, no resistance, so E and F together. Then afterwards, Aram said, very simply, between what two terminals? Between A and C we have 4 ohm, right? Between A and C we have 4. Like that you draw, the circuit analysis becomes very simple for you. I hope you have understood it. Numerical 2. In the circuit diagram shown in figure, the potentials of the points B, C, D are respectively. So how to find it? So I'll explain to you how simple it is. This minus and this minus are connected together and connected to zero potential. When this is zero, here we have plus 12, here we have plus 6. First step is the corners A, so simple. Here 12 volt, here 6 volt. This is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. The question is potential at B, C, D. They are asking what is the resistance here, 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm. First of all, what is the total resistance of this branch? It is 1 plus 2 plus 3, which is 6 ohm. Here we have 12 volt, here we have 6 volt. How much is dropped across this series combination then? 12 minus 6, 6 volt. I hope you have understood. Here we have 12 volt, here we have 6 volt. That means how much is dropped across the combination? 6 volt. 6 volt means voltage drop across A and D is 6 volt. So what is the current flowing through it? VAD by R total, which is 6 by 6, that is 1 ampere. So through each a current of 1 ampere flows, 1 ampere, 1 ampere. So what is the drop across this? 1 volt. What is the drop across this? 2 volt. What is the drop across this? 3 volt. Now come to the point. How much is the potential? What is the potential at A? 12 volt. How much is dropped? 1. So you are left with 11 volt. Got it? Okay. After 11, how much is? Here it is. 2. You have lost 2 here. 2 is dropped. So you are left with 9 volt. Here 3 volt is dropped. You are left with 6. So at B, the potential is 11 volt. At C, it is 9 volt. At D, it is 6 volt. 11 comma 9 comma 6. Understood? Understood, children? Got the concept? So whenever the such questions come, very simple idea is, first of all, split it. Here imagine there is 12 volt. Here imagine plus 6 volt. Because these two are connected together and connected to zero potential. So here take plus 12 volt, here you take plus 6 volt. Here 12, here 6, the remaining is dropped across the combination, which is 6 volt, like this. I hope you have understood. Next, this question is based on a simple formula. Variation of resistance of a conductor with the temperature is as shown. Why I am talking about conductor? Because the slope is positive, so definitely it is a conductor. They are asking temperature coefficient of resistance of the conductor, T. temperature coefficient of resistance of the conductor. So we know that temperature coefficient is RT minus R naught by R naught into T. This is the actual formula. Here in this R naught RT minus R naught by T, what is this? dr by dt. This is 1 by R naught. dr by dt is slope of the graph. Slope of RT graph is dr by dt. In this question, they have mentioned that slope is m. So alpha is obtained as dr by dt is m. And this is given already, which is R naught. So what is the answer then? M by R naught. Done. So simple it is. See, this question is framed just by the definition. Just if you read the definition of alpha once, then it is very simple for you to understand. This is 1 by R naught dr by dt. Okay, dr by dt is rate of variation of resistance with temperature. R naught is resistance at zero or resistance at T naught temperature. Then number 4. A circuit consists of three identical lamps connected to a battery as shown in the figure. When the switch S is closed, then the intensities of lamps A and B. What happens to the intensities of lamps? First, the switch is opened. Switch open. When the switch is open, we have three bulbs A, B, and C. All the three bulbs are identical. Identical, obviously. See, when they are identical, it's simple that the total voltage is V. Suppose each bulb will take V by 3 volt drop across it. V by 3, V by 3, V by 3. So what is the power? Means the wattage, the power, because intensity depends on consumed power. So the consumed power by each bulb PA, PB, or of course PC also is same. Let it be P. P equal to the formula for power is V square by R. So here drop across each bulb is V by 3. So V by 3 whole square by R. Because we have considered in the question, it is given that the three lamps are identical. So their resistances are equal. So each one is having a resistance of capital R. So I took it as capital R. So I am getting V square by 9R. So the power consumed by the bulbs in the first case when switch is open is equal to V square by 9R. Next, when switch is closed, when you close the switch, what happens? Bulb C does not glow at all because no current flows through the bulb C, because bulb C is connected across a short circuit. This we call it as short circuit. This is bulb A and bulb B. So no current flows through this, no current and no drop across this. So total voltage is V. Across this, V by 2. Across this, V by 2. So in A and in B, in this case, it is V square by R. V square by 4 by R, you will get V square by 4R. This is the power. So here you can simply take V square by R as 9 times PA. Here PA dash or PB dash are equal to 1 by 4 times V square by R, that is 9 PA, which is 9 by 4 times PA. That is 2.25 times PA. So the brightness or intensity. Brightness increases in lamps A and B. Brightness increases by 2.25 times, which is more than 2 times, which is more than 2 times. I hope you have understood. So brightness depends on the voltage drop across each bulb, because this is a simple series combination. I have selected in the next video, I have selected one parallel combination also. I will discuss that, right? The last numerical for this session, they are asking us to find potential difference between A and B. So you need to know how to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law to a branch. How to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law to a branch. Here, let us take the potential VA. Here the potential is VB. You know the convention rule that we follow in Kirchhoff's voltage law. In the direction of current, if there is any drop across resistance, that drop is to be taken as negative. So when you are traversing a loop, suppose if you are traversing the battery from positive to negative, that is fall off potential, that is to be taken as negative. Suppose if you are traveling from minus to plus, it is rise of potential, that is positive. Simple convention is fall off potential is negative, rise of potential is positive. Suppose in case of a resistor, current flows like this, you are traversing in the same direction, this potential drop is taken as minus IR. Suppose current is traveling like this and you are measuring the potential drop opposite to it, you are traveling opposite to the current. Current flows from higher potential to lower potential. Here, this is fall of potential. This is rise of potential. This potential difference is taken as minus R. This potential difference is to be taken as plus R. Next, in case you are traversing through a cell like this, from positive to negative, this is fall of potential. We should take its EMF as minus E. Suppose if you are traversing the loop from minus to plus, this is rise of potential. In this case, delta V equal to plus E. Understand? So now we let us start. Let the potential be VA here. Through 6 ohm, 2 ampere is flowing. You are traversing in this direction. So you are traversing in the direction of current. So I into R, 6 into 2 is 12. So it is minus 12. Plus 2 minus across the cell, minus 12. 9 into 2, minus 18. Minus 2 plus, rise of potential, plus 4. In the direction of current, 5 into current is same, 2 ampere. 5 into 2, 10. It is equal to VB. So VA minus of this is equal to VB. So you get 12, so 24 minus 18, minus 42, plus minus 10, minus 52, VA minus 52 plus 4 is equal to VB, VA minus 48 is equal to VB, VA minus VB equal to 48 volt. This is the answer. Done. So for the previous case, third option, for this question, second option is the answer. The previous one, alpha equal to m by R naught, this is the answer. For the second question, second option, first question, second option, these are the five numericals I have selected. Enjoying the videos. I'm expecting feedback from you in the comments box. Thank you. Thank you very much.